In the first place. So how are you going around here spewing rhetoric? Oh, Ahmose don't fuck with his father. How? 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 I don't even know him to fuck with him.
My father is Dr. Malachi Z. York, so I've always been around an abundance of knowledge.
I don't even know him to fuck with him. I don't even know him to fuck with him. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't have no real stance towards Malachi Z. York in the first place. That's not my arena. You want me to have a stance.
My father, Dr. Malachi Z. York, so I've always been around in abundance of knowledge.
What up? You want me to have a stance with him. I don't have no stance with and or against Malachi Z. York. And I am not obliged, I am not obligated to have one. And I'm not obligated to be a student, especially when I do not want none of the connotations that come with them. Especially when I grew up with the rhetoric that I am the son of a pedophile. That I am the son of a pedophile. Why the fuck would I have a positive perspective on claiming to be Malachi Z. York's son, which is why, I don't know if you noticed, I don't ever say my father, my father, my father, my father.
My father, my father, my father. Dr. Malachi Z. York, so I'm
like the Yorks do. I say Malachi Z. York because I had to be conditioned and adapt to environments, the real world, fuck this community shit, the real world where he is viewed as a pedophile and as running a criminal organization. That's how he's viewed. So when I would even slip up and tell people who and what my biological father, because nigga, I don't come from that weird Nuwaupian background community. My bad, like, and
so I'm the Most High. Like, y'all can follow me on IG if y'all haven't already. So I break down universal truth, like right knowledge, right wisdom, and right understanding. My science is Nuwaupu. My science is Nuwaupu. My science is Nuwaupu. I get it directly, like directly from the source. You know, I was raised in the community. I was born in the community. I was born like around the era of Tamaray.
See, like, listen. I ain't dissonant. I'm just saying that I come from the real outside world. I don't come from that world where y'all niggas think that Malachi Z. York is the king. No one has ever taught me that, nigga. Like, that's not something that I was ever privy to. Now I'm saying I come from the real world where, nigga, if I slipped up and told anybody that I was Malachi Z. York's son, my nigga, like my own mother told me that. See, I could be harmed.
My father is Dr. Malachi Z. York, so.
Now I'm saying just on behalf of what they feel as if he did. So my nigga, absolutely not. That has been carried with me to this day. Cause I come from the real world. Everyone doesn't think like you. So see, you want me to risk my life on your behalf. You want me to risk my, you know, my connections, my relationships on your behalf. You want me to risk whatever I got going on your behalf. Knowing that Dr. Malachi, that name is the biggest black male one could ever fucking carry.
My father is Dr. Malachi Z. York, so
that is blackmail in itself. What are you talking about? So every time y'all even say, oh, that's Malachi, that's blackmail. I'm like, yo, I wanted to stop saying that. Only reason I'm like, yo, phase one, phase ones that I keep saying, fucking, they keep tying me to Malachi. Like, that's blackmail. It don't matter if I believe it happened and or not. It don't matter if I believe it happened and or not. It don't matter what I think of the nigga. It matters how is this gonna affect my reality? Because I exist in reality. I don't go to the Nuwaupian bookstore. I don't chill around the Nuwaupians. I don't date, nigga, like, I don't talk to Nuwaupian females.
Let's get to the first question. How do you and your bloodline get all into the consciousness of spirituality and healing the world?
Honestly, so although, like, the information was always made available to me due to, like, my family, right? But when they did take away Tamaray around May 8, 2002, a lot of people left the community. And, like, due to a lot of people leaving the community, some of us were actually robbed of these experiences of being able to really experience the land as much. You know, like, Tamaray went down when I was about 3 years old. So when we left, you know, we was outside in the world. And, like, as being outside in the world, you know, like, some people got lost, and even some people went straight back to Christianity, you know, just trying to find a way. So how I got into this was I ended up returning back into Nuwaupu when I moved back up to Brooklyn in New York. I went straight to Bushwick and Hart Street. That's the headquarters of, like, of the Nuwaupian Nation.
I don't go to the Nuwaupian bookstore. I don't chill around the Nuwaupians. I don't...
Bushwick and Hart Street. Now, I was about 17. Remember, I left. You know, I was on some knucklehead shit at the time. I wasn't really the best. You know, like, I got removed from public school and all that. So, when I went up to New York is when I first got exposed to the doctrine heavily. Outside of that, I was just regular on the outside world. But, like, when I got exposed to the doctrine heavily up there, I was still kind of reluctant. I wasn't really open to it as much because, you know, like, I was still on, like a money tip. Like, you know, I was up there trying to see if I could make some bread. Like, being 17 years old up there in New York by myself in a building full of, you know, other Nuwaupians.
I don't chill around the Nuwaupians. I don't...
People at that time. You feel me? So that was, like, one of the first times I really got exposed to the information or the doctrine. And even then, you know, I would constantly ask the brothers, like, how is this going to put food on my table? Because, you know, it was times up there where I would go a long time without, you know, like, eating or consuming anything. Like, you know, and not even just on no fasting deliberately. It was, like, a thing to where I went up there with the intentions of, you know, like, up there fending for yourself and whatnot. I wasn't able to get a job in New York at 17 due to the fact that I didn't have parents to sign off on paperwork. I didn't really have that at the time. So, you know, I would have to find other means to try and, you know, come across some bread back then. But a good brother did suggest something that did get me to start reading the books and getting into the information.
I don't chill around the Nuwaupians. I don't...
What he had told me was, you know, like, something that a lot of the brothers do, like, in the culture in Nuwaupu, that they go out and they propagate it. They go out and they sell books and incense. They go and talk to the people. So one suggestion that they did give me was that somebody did give me was, you know, that one way that you could acquire money, because I would always ask, how is this information? How is this knowledge? Like, I don't get how it's gonna get me forward, because right now I'm in the root chakra. Like, in the root chakra is what is based off of survival and security. And that was what I needed at that time. So I'm like, yo, I can't transcend past and go into the higher chakras if I'm still, I haven't conquered the root chakra. Because in order to achieve your higher chakras, gotta balance out your lower chakras. So that's where I was at with it. And then a brother made a good point. He was saying, you know, well, one thing that you could do is that you could read and study all that information. You could try and sell these books to people, you know, and whatnot. And that's how I first really got into the information. I was like, all right. And that's what really encouraged me to start reading and studying the information. It was because, like, I was at a point in time, I was in my root chakra. And then I worked my way up to where I am now.
All right.
Like, now I'm saying, like, that's not what I do. Contrary to what phase one is saying, like, oh, this nigga says that he can get any bitch he wants while saying he's daughter or son. Nigga, that doesn't even make no motherfucking sense. Nigga, I've lost entire nigga. Like, I've had nigga growing up, childhood, I had people who kept their kids away from me if and when they knew who Pops was. If they knew who my father was, they kept their kids from playing with me as a child. Now I'm saying, like, I've talked to females whose parents said, oh no, you can't talk to that nigga. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't come from the world where I'm targeting and going after Nuwaupians. You know what I'm saying? I wasn't even around that shit. I was kept far the fuck away from it.
I was raised in the community. I was born in the community. I was born, like, around the era of Tamaray.
So, nigga, when I came to this, it was on my own accord. And when I did, I was damn near homeless up in Brooklyn, New York. That was the first time in a long time, since I was a baby perhaps, that I even came in contact with the Nuwaupian Nation. I was damn near homeless in fucking Brooklyn. Fucking scraping up quarters, like, in this fucking busted down ass fucking building, trying to buy a fucking sandwich. In 7-Eleven off Bushwick and Hart Street in Brooklyn, New York. That's the closest I came to it. And even then, that shit was of no benefit to me.
And then a brother made a good point. He was saying, you know, well, one thing that you could do is that you could read and study all that information. You could try to sell these books to people, you know, and whatnot. And that's how I first really got into the information. I was like, all right. And that's what really encouraged me to start reading and studying the information. It was because, like, I was at a point in time, I was in my root chakra. And then I worked my way up.
It to me. Cause nigga, I'm around a whole Nuwaupian based bookstore, whatever, my nigga. Like, nigga, I'm still struggling. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm not eating every day. I got rings around my eyes. For me, like, I'm sleeping in a fucking building with no heating, a whole fucking brownstone. I gotta sleep in fucking four fucking jackets and shit like that on the floor. You know what I'm saying? Like, that name did nothing positive for me. Why would I rep it? Why would I rep it? It did nothing positive for me. It did nothing good for me. You know the history that shapes, history is what shapes people's psychology. I have a history that shapes why I don't claim Dr. Malachi. Y'all, like, the other Yorks, they may claim, oh yeah, I was in Brooklyn too. Nah, nigga, y'all was in Brooklyn in a safe Nuwaupian community at a safer time and place. Y'all grew up around Nuwaupians who fed y'all the rhetoric that Dr. York was God. I didn't have that rhetoric fed to me at no point in time. Never. I've never had that rhetoric fed to me. I was told I lived in houses with people who hated Malachi Z. York. I was 9 years old, right? I was staying with this elder who tried to sue Dr. York. I remember 9 years old, I'm asking him about my father. Yo, I'm like, cause listen, no one ever told me. My own mother won't even tell me my fucking, or see, my mother fears me going on the internet to fucking find things. So I asked this old man, I asked him, did you know my father? He said, yes. I'm like, okay, cool. What kind of man was he? That nigga said the damn devil. And then he passed me a whole book on Dr. Malachi Z. York, slandering him, right? Called ungodly. And told me to read that book. Every chance I get, he remind me, your father was a goddamn devil. This is childhood. Know what I'm saying? So I don't remember at no point in time in my childhood in Pine Hills, Florida, in West Orlando. I remember at no point in time, like when I was in Atlanta, when I was in Florida, when I was in New York, at no point in time was that shit ever a fucking positive.
You're highlighting today's you being the son of Dr. Malachi York, and you show a heightened degree of knowledge, which is like very rare right now because people, you know, community, they really focus on pleasure this, pleasure that. Well, you have knowledge. How has you being a York affected your life?
How has being a York affected my life? Honestly, it comes with a lot of expectations. You know, a lot of people, they have set expectations for, you know, how you should be or what you should talk about and whatnot. So now, if we look at York and whatnot, it's a label, right? And that we know that labels can be a manifestation of one's ego and it can limit people as well. So now that's the cons of also carrying certain names and titles, because you're running with a title which already has a set reputation. You follow me? So I mean, it had pros and it had cons. Like, there's a good and a bad to everything.
So I don't get why the fuck y'all want me to be going around here yelling that name as if the name does not come with a stench to it.
My father is Dr. Malachi Z. York, so I
miss me with that. Your opinions is not gonna put me at risk. know what I'm saying? Because my nigga, like, you make up, and that's not an attack on like any one of you, but y'all make up a small mind. I lived in Pine Hills, Florida, West Orlando, War Orlando. Know what I'm saying? Like, I lived in Pine Hills, Florida, Pinedale Avenue. Know what I'm saying? I lived there for like 5 years of my life, right? Okay. So look, y'all make up a small minority of people. A small minority. Y'all don't make up the big majority. And y'all, like, mind you, y'all been arguing with the large majority for like 22 years of my fucking life. And y'all haven't convinced these niggas yet that Dr. York was innocent. Y'all haven't cleared up this man's yet, but you want people to claim the shit? You should be, instead of wanting people to claim Malachi Z. York's name, instead of wanting people to claim Malachi Z. York's name,
my father is Dr. Malachi Z. York, so
perhaps clear the name up so that it can be claimed. So that it can be claimed. Clear the name up so that it can be claimed. You know what I'm saying? Oh, why is the 19 Keys saying, I fear 19 Keys better not say Dr. York's name. You're going to get canceled. Like, nigga, I fear. Because my nigga, listen, I have post-traumatic stress disorder off claiming Dr. York's name. I'm like, nah, don't do it. Don't do it.
My father is Dr. Malachi Z. York, so I...
Whatever you do, don't let this nigga, don't let this nigga peer pressure you into saying Malachi Z. York's name. Don't. They're going to cancel you. That's going to be used against you. Did the same thing to African Bambaataa. When African Bambaataa went down for fucking pedophilia, what the first thing they did was like say, oh, he was connected to pedophile Dr. Malachi Z. York.
Rap, which we're doing today, started from a whole cultural movement. Not too many people know about that, but you know, it's a cultural movement of the hip hop era. Started like around mid-70s, you know. And you know, this movement was started by people such as African Bambaataa.
This is definitely a case that needs to be open. It needs to be open for all the public to see, for all the public to view, for all the public to get an understanding, so we could get the right knowledge, the right wisdom, and the right understanding of what has happened to our brother, Dr. Malachi Z. York. And if this can happen to him, just imagine what can happen to you.
Nigga, when Prince York went down, my brother went down, he said, yo, son of cult leader, child molester, gets locked up for abusing children. Nigga, even Nature Boy's being tied back to hell no.
Type gods were hermaphrodites. Go look it up. It's called the Egyptian third gender. Google the Egyptian third gender and read the creation story in Egypt. This is our knowledge, our original knowledge. That's why I'm attracted to transsexuals, because I already know that hermaphrodites were the original gods. Those are the gods. It said the archetype. The archetype was hermaphrodite, period. Those are the real gods. This world is so demonic that they don't even accept the gods. The archetype, the beings that come here with two spirits, are the archetypes. They are the gods.
Well, I'm out, man. That nigga's tripping.
Hey, everybody. How y'all doing today? Welcome to my live. So, I'm here with my homeboy, Tumamoon. I'm in my neighborhood with my Nuwaupian friend. And... Rahubat, hello. So today we're going to teach a lesson, and one of the lessons is we're going to teach about gays. And the reason why I wanted to share this, guys, with you all is because I wanted you guys to really understand the history of homosexuality and gayness on this planet. So Amun, tell us what you know about the gays on this planet.
Right now, this is a hot topic. It's very prevalent that we know what we're talking about when we talk about homosexuality. We're not talking about the religious homosexuality that you see with the Bible, the misinterpretation of Sodom and Gomorrah, but more so, if you go to Africa, androgynous beings or neutrosexual beings were at the forefront of creation when it came to the African mysteries or the African ancient text. When you come to ancient Egypt, these were... For lack of a better word, these were the precursors of our race, essentially.
Like, so they were the first people here, right?
The first being, neutered. And they were both. So in our language, Semitic, we say muknash tattoo.
for a male hemorphodite, and Muknash for a male hemorphodite. So it's two, not necessarily, you have one aspect where they have a phallus, a penis, and a vagina as well.
Mm-hmm.
These beings, that's like a more so of a deformity. What we're talking about is a spiritual aspect. So most homosexual people, I want to get the right term, I don't say gays, but most
What?
My science is Nuwaupian. I get it directly, like directly from the source, you know.